Hi friends, welcome to Learn Entomology, Entomology Information Series 1. I am your Senthil Raja. Have you ever seen this type of questions? Pick the odd man out. The option A, honeybee. Option B, housefly. Option C, bumblebee. Option D, blackfly. I asked the same question to my friends. They answered me. First, the option A is right. Honeybee. I asked the reason. They said to me, honeybee is a beneficial insect and others are not the beneficial insect. So honeybee is the answer. But the answer is not the honeybee, because you can see the option C, bumblebee. Bumblebee is also a beneficial insect. It helps in pollination. Okay, I said this thing to my friends and they suddenly said that option B is the answer. Housefly is a vector for many diseases, that like they said. But here you have to see the option D, blackfly. It is also the vector of river blindness. Okay. Moreover, the honeybee and bumblebee belongs to the same order Hymenoptera, and the housefly and blackfly belongs to the same order Diptera. What may be the answer? The concept of this question is somewhat different and it was somewhat interesting. And here I am not going to give answer for this question, but instead I am going to provide you the concept to which this question belongs to, and so that you can answer this question whenever it is asked in the examination. Okay. I am sure that by the end of this video you are not only able to answer these type of questions, but also you will be able to know how to write the common names of the insects. Let me see the concept behind this. According to the Entomological Society of America, when a species is a true example of a particular taxon, that taxon is written separately. What did you understand? What is a taxon, first of all? A taxon is nothing but a taxonomic group of any rank, such as species, family, or an order. Okay, what is order? For example, Hymenoptera. Hymenoptera is an order. We can say it as a taxon. Okay. See this concept with an example. Okay. Consider a taxon, Diptera. Okay. It includes a group of insects. Those are collectively called as true flies. Okay. The example of true flies are the housefly, blackfly, stemfly, fruitfly, robberfly. While writing these common names, you must have to provide a gap between the two words. Okay, here you can see housefly, there is a gap between this, and blackfly, there is a gap between this, and the next one, stemfly, there is a gap, and so on. Okay, these are called as true flies. Then who are not the true flies? Fly. The butterfly belongs to the order Lepidoptera, so it is not considered as a true fly. Okay, while writing these names, you must not provide gap between the two words. It must be considered as a single word. Okay, the other such examples are sawfly, which belongs to the order Hymenoptera, and the dragonfly, which belongs to the order Odonata, and the caddisfly, which belongs to the order Trichoptera. Okay. And there is another example for you. Consider the order Hemiptera. The insects belonging to the Hemiptera are called as true bugs. Okay. Example of such true bugs are lacewing bugs, stink bugs, spittle bugs, aeroplane bugs. Okay. While writing these names, you must have to provide a gap between the two words. Okay, let we see in the true bugs. Then, who are not a true bugs? Ladybugs. Ladybugs are nothing but the coccinellid beetles, which belongs to the order Coleoptera, are called as ladybugs. I hope you understood the topic. The question is back. Pick the odd man out. Option A, honeybee. Option B, housefly. Option C, bumblebee. Option D, blackfly. Friends, pick the answer and comment the answer in the comment box. Thank you, my dear friends. I will see you in another interesting topic. Like and subscribe to Learn Entomology if you understood the today's topic, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Contact me at learnentomology@gmail.com.